This video is in response to a question by Sandeep Saraf Kumar, and I apologize for it not coming out sooner, so I made a video to try to make up for that. Anyways, if you take a look at the Microsoft documentation for table valued procedures, and we just literally copy that and we paste it into Visual Studio, you're going to want to download the AdventureWorks 2012 OLTP version. I know it's old and I'm running SQL 2017, but we could still use the 2012. And the reason we're doing that is the example database is the AdventureWorks 2012. So I know it's going to have the right tables, etc. Once you finish downloading the backup file, stick it in the folder where you're running your SQL Server or your SQL Server Express so you can restore it. Got an empty database here. Go tasks, restore, database. We're going to choose device so we could pick from a file and hit browse. Hit add, go to the location where your AdventureWorks has been downloaded. As you can see, the LT is that light version, and here's the full one. I'll hit OK. OK, and then I'm going to go to options. In options, I'm going to click overwrite and hit OK. Progress should show in your top right. And once it gets to 100%, you should see a pop-up saying it's restored. Now we can go back to Visual Studio, and I've already pasted it in here. So I've got a breakpoint on the exec line. If you don't reach the breakpoint, then that means you've got an error. You're going to have to look in your output. You might see something like this, like I didn't have the table when I ran it last time. So on your far left, hit that drop down, click Execute with Debugger. Hit F11 to go through each item. Once you get down to the exec, hit F11 again. It'll have to take you into the stored procedure that you want to debug. And I believe that was your question. Can I debug stored procedures if they're returning a table? Clarify me if it was a different question. So go ahead and hit F11 or F10 here. And hopefully you're able to debug your stored procedure.